Hey, Andrei. Hey.
A similar question in a different context, in the context of Ukraine.
Sure.
May 2nd marks the second anniversary of an atrocious event in modern history in Ukraine, where some peaceful protesters were driven into a administrative building and basically burned alive. 48 people lost their lives, hundreds were injured. The U.S. condemned the event. My question is, first, what has been done, if anything, to make sure that those responsible were brought to justice? And then and the second question is about the commemoration this coming May 2, but that's the next question.
Okay, no worries. No, obviously, there is the, we are coming up on, as you note, the two-year anniversary of the fire in Odessa that killed, I think, more than 40 people. And we, first of all, we can extend our condolences to the people of Ukraine on the second anniversary of this horrific event. That, as you note, occurred on May 2nd, 2014. We did obviously condemn it strongly at the time. I believe Secretary Kerry condemned the violence and said that that includes the violence of anyone who lit a fire and caused the death of those 38 people or more in the building in Odessa, and that all of this violence, and I'm quoting Secretary Kerry, is unacceptable. And Russia, the United States, Ukrainians, Europeans, and the OSCE, all of us bear responsibility to do everything in our power to reduce the capacity of militants and extremists to carry out these kind of violent activities and terrorist activities. In terms of, as you know, we did call for a thorough investigation, as did other governments at the time, into the those actions on Odessa. I would refer you and have to refer you, I can't speak on behalf of the Ukrainian government on how that investigation has proceeded and who ultimately has been found culpable for the actions in Odessa.
I'm afraid not much has happened about that. And my question was what, if anything, the U.S. could do to speed the process along,
sure,
or maybe to bring it to a resolution that would be at least understandable to the victims, to the relatives
well,
of the victims.
Well, sure, Andre. Well, in any case like this, as I said, it's you know, it was a horrific event, and in any kind of event like this, there needs to be a resolution. There needs to be a closure, and so that's what an investigation and again, bringing those who are carried out this act to justice would bring to the victims of the attack and the families of the victims of the attack. You know, we'll continue to make that message or convey that message to the Ukrainian authorities, but I would refer you to them for more details on that investigation.
And then secondly, the coming up anniversary will be marked by people there who just remember those who they lost. But the opposite side, quote unquote, the people who do not want those commemorations are already threatening that they will disrupt the proceedings, they will physically prevent the events from happening. My question to you is, if is the U.S. government ready to do anything, anything in its power to prevent another outburst of violence in Odessa on May 2nd? And what can you do? You have diplomatic presence there, right?
In Odessa? No, we don't.
You don't? No consulate?
No, I don't believe so. Okay. I'll double check on that.
Okay.
But no, we don't.
So
but that said, we do have, you know, obviously, you know, look, Andre, I mean, broadly speaking, over the past several years, we've had an ongoing partnership with law enforcement authorities in Ukraine, where we've done extensive training with them on how to handle, among other things, civil unrest. But look, the most important thing to stress here is that we would obviously support any commemoration of this event. But as with any commemoration, it needs to be done nonviolently, and we would certainly condemn any threats in the run-up to this these events or this commemoration. and call on all sides to show restraint.
Mm-hmm.
Please, and, in the back, last question.
If I may,
yes, just last question.
If I just wanted to, yes, to end on this subject.
Yeah.
Are you aware that a group of human rights and anti-war activists are traveling there from the U.S. as well as from other countries? Would you support such a mission?
I don't know anything about the group, Andre. I'd have to find out more details about what who they are and what their intent is before I would comment on it.
Ukraine.
Yeah. Let's make this the last question, guys.
Okay.
Yeah.
Today, Russian
10 or 12? Okay, good. Fair enough.
Today, Russian authority in Crimea declared the Mejlis of the Crimean Tatar people as an extremist organization and banned its activities. The Department of State previously paid attention to this issue, but there is no positive decision from the Russian side. What is your reaction now, and what specific steps are you going to do?
Apologies, you're talking about the ban on Crimean Tatars?
Mejlis.
Yeah, Mejlis, right, exactly. Well, we did put out a statement on April 21st. We called on the Russian Federation to reverse the Ministry of Justice's recent decision to designate this, the Mejlis, as you note, as an extremist organization, as well as a decision by de facto authorities in Crimea to suspend this democratic institution. You know, we're obviously disturbed that by the reports banning the Mejlis Council, because frankly it removes what little representation and recourse that the Tatars have left under Russian occupation. The Tatars face oppression, they face repression, they face discrimination in Russian-occupied Crimea. Almost 10,000 of them have been forced to flee their homeland, and those who remain have been subjected to abuses, beatings, arbitrary detentions, et cetera. And these brutalities and human rights abuses must end. As to what next, you know that we have sanctions in place. We do not accept Russia's occupation of Crimea. Those sanctions will remain in place until Crimea ends its occupation of Crimea. What did I say? I apologize.
Crimea ends.
I apologize. Until Russia ends its Crimea, occupation of Crimea. And we also reaffirm our support for Ukraine's sovereignty. Please, Matt.